Live investigates a major victory for the only school in the country that uses painful electric shocks on its disabled students.
That's right. Mike Bonet has been covering this controversy for years. He's here with details about a new court decision in this. Mike.
Yeah, Ben, a Bristol County judge has sided with the Judge Rotenberg Center in Canton, allowing the school to continue using electric shocks on its students. And tonight, a parents group at the school is welcoming that decision, saying the state tried unsuccessfully to discredit the school.
Andrea, now I found directions to take your jacket off.
This controversial treatment will continue at the Judge Rotenberg Center in Canton, at least for now. In 2013, soon after this video became public, former Governor Deval Patrick's administration tried to put a stop to this practice known as an aversive treatment. But a judge just denied the motion, saying the state failed to demonstrate that there is now a professional consensus that the level 3 aversive treatment used at JRC does not conform to the accepted standard of care for treating individuals with intellectual and developmental disabilities.
Obviously, it's controversial.
Governor Baker's Health and Human Services Secretary Mary Lou Sutters says the state must now decide whether to appeal.
Do you think they should be continuing to use them?
So what we know is that the use of positive reinforcement is generally accepted practice for a very small number of individuals with very extreme behaviors.
Is the Baker administration more open to this than the Patrick administration's?
It's not about whether we're more open or not. What is important is that the Commonwealth, when there is a consent decree, that we ensure we do everything possible, right, to comply with a court order.
Earlier this month, protesters gathered outside the Judge Rotenberg Center, where nearly 60 students are approved to receive electric skin shocks. They're calling on the Food and Drug Administration to act on its 2016 proposal to ban the electric shock devices.
Absolutely, this is torture.
The FDA says it's reviewing comments on the proposed ban, and that decision could still put an end to the electric shocks. As for the Massachusetts ruling, we should know in the next 30 days whether the state will appeal the judge's decision. Mike Bodette, 5 Investigate.